Hello guys, welcome to my channel. Today we are going to compare three 3D scanners, and now we are going to see about their performance and all of the stuff. The selected 3D scanners for today's videos. Today's video is the first one is the Artek Eva. The second one is the RevoPoint Pop. The Artek Eva is basically a very renowned 3D scanner, although it is quite old, but still it's been many professionals are actually using this one. This RevoPoint Pop is basically a new scanner and it has been presented on Kickstarter. So I have just contacted RevoPoint to send me the scanner for a review. And the third one is basically the Sense 2 3D scanner. Now we are going to see whether all of these scanners, how they are going to perform, what are their basic qualities, and what kind of a user is basically they are meant for. So for these three 3D scanners, we are going to compare their scan quality first. Then we are going to see their usability and form factors. After that, we are going to see their prices, comparative prices, and then we are going to see the pros and cons of all of these 3D scanners. So guys, I have opened the three scans, and basically I have scanned myself with these three presented 3D scanners. This most left hand side scan is basically from Artek, and the middle one is from RevoPoint Pop, and the right one is basically the Sense 2 3D face scanner. As you can see from the first impressions, I can see over here that I have numbered it according to the details. So I personally think so that this is the most detailed scan from Artek, and this scanner is quite good enough. Although it is so portable and so tiny and so small, but still it has actually captured a lot of great details, especially as you can see the curves over here from the cloths, and similarly the things are very much clear and detailed for RevoPoint Pop. And for this scanner, which is the Sense 2, I don't see many details over here, and I think so that the overall structure is going to be okay, but the details are not according to the mark. Details is basically about the polygons or vertices count. So as you can see over here, the bottom part of the screen is it's basically their vertices and triangle counts have been written. So for this particular Artek face scan, I think so that 1.2 million triangles have been formed and have been captured by using this scanner. And as you can see over here, it is quite detailed and quite good looking to me. The curves and the details are quite okay. And if you want to see in the details that what I am actually meaning by the rectangle count, so go over here, view, and show the wireframe. So now the wireframe are basically the unit for 3D modeling. So if we can see over here, there are plenty of wireframe. The wireframe structure is so detailed. The more the detailed structure will be, the more you can do some design work over here, and you can use this particular model for a better ground for designing something like goggles, something face mask or something like that, and to be further work on in any 3D software. So I personally think so this particular scanner has captured so much details, especially around the face and with the clothes as well. Coming towards the Pop scanner, as you can see over here, the details are quite good, but not that much excellent as compared to the Artek Eva. The details are quite good, and if we just compare the size of this scanner has actually, in comparison to their size, it actually has accumulated quite a good detail. especially the curves of the cloth and the structure of this, the face and all of the features over here. And it has actually generated this whole mesh by using like 0.8 million triangle counts. So in comparison to the ArcTech, this triangle count is a little bit lesser, but if we just see the details, so I think so for a design work, this particular scan can actually work. Coming towards the third scan, which is by Sense 2, this scan is quite okay for replicating the model, but I don't see many applications in terms of design, in terms of taking it out into 3D software. If we just switch it on the wireframe view and switch it on the wireframe view over here as well for the pop scanner, so you can see the difference of details over here between these two scanners. So firstly, I personally think so that the more the detailed model will be, it will be actually more good and more reliable and accurate while performing some design tasks by using any 3D software, whether the 3D software is Rhino or 3ds Max or whatsoever the software is. I think so the more detailed and accurate polygons are going to perform better. Now we will talk about some usability and form factor. So firstly, we'll talk about the ArcTech EVA. As you can see over here, ArcTech EVA is quite heavy, and you need to hold the computer to see the scan. And this is not very much friendly for me, to be honestly speaking, because it was quite heavy, and for scanning myself, I need someone else to scan myself. And for self-scanning and for the rest of the things, it requires a lot of effort. But the positive thing is that this switching between switch on, record and pause and these kind of operations can also be operated by the scanner as well. And you can see the buttons over here. This scanner actually provides the option that you can start this and stop this from the device. Overall, the form factor is okay, but it is quite heavy for a person, and for the longer period of hours, I think so it is it will be quite heavy. The next scanner is RevoPoint Pop. I must appreciate one thing, that this is so small and tiny, and this form factor is so good. You can scan yourself by using just a single hand of yours, and you can scan all of the objects around you by using this particular scanner. It can actually attach with your mobile apps as well, so you can use it on your mobile phone. For the Sense 2, this particular scanner is lightweight, it's okay, but the form factor is very much similar to the ArcTech EVA. And I personally think so that the problems with ArcTech EVA are similar with this scanner, but it's the only, you can see the lighter weight version of the ArcTech. Although the quality is not that much good as compared to ArcTech. Coming towards the prices of these 3D scanners and how much they actually cost, so all the prices are in US dollars. So for the first one, ArcTech EVA has basically two models. The first one is the ArcTech EVA, and one is the lighter version. So it's all about 16,600 US dollar, and the lighter version is available in 8,200 USDs. Coming towards the RevoPoint Pop, it's quite cheap and quite astonishing price it actually have as compared to the results. It is actually 500 US dollars. And Sense 2 is basically about 499 US dollars. All of the prices are current, and it's basically January of 2021. So I have checked onto the internet, these prices are current. Let's come towards the pros and cons of these 3D scanners, how they are going to be effective, and what are their special point saving features. So coming towards the ArcTech, it actually has higher accuracy, very higher detail model, higher polygonal count. It is quite excellent for scan and print application. If you just want to scan and then afterwards you need to print it, it is quite excellent. It is a very excellent scanner for 3D modeling. Using any design software, the polygonal count and the rest of the things which actually need to be used by the 3D modeling software is quite good. The cons are basically it's very, very expensive, it's very heavy and very difficult to scan yourself, and it requires yearly maintenance plan as well, and it has actually a proprietary software. Although the options and different things, operations in the software is quite good, but I personally think so this is quite suitable for very specialized work, because I don't consider this one as a value of money. If you have very particular application in your mind and very high accuracy you require, then probably you can use this scanner. Coming towards the RevoPoint Pop, so the pros are so much. It has good accuracy, it has detailed model, it has good polygonal count and scan, great for scan, it is very good for 3D modeling, quite low price. I just consider this a value for money, and I am really very impressed by the form factor, which is very small, very light, and as compared to the quality with Arctic scanners, I think so. I'm not saying that it is giving quite a competition to the scanner, but I think so that it has a good ability to capture a lot of good details. According to my point of view, the cons are usually while operating the scanner is basically it has to start and stop only by using the software. So if you're using the mobile, then probably start and stop feature would be okay for you, no problem. But if you are using laptop and other stuff, then it is quite difficult to actually start and stop by using the software. It is not very much suitable for darker objects, but only basic options available with the handy scan software which comes with the remote. Comes with the Sense 2. It, as compared to the price, it details are okay. It is low price, but in comparison to the RevoPoint, the price is so much similar. So the results are not that much great. It is lightweight, and I think so. RevoPoint has given this particular scanner a great competition in terms of quality. The cons are too much, because it has very less polygonal count. Scanner print require some tweaks. You need to be expert in how to treat different things in using the 3D meshing software. I don't think it is very much good for 3D modeling. Very low accuracy and start and stop only by the software, and only the basic options are available in the software. So form factor, for myself, I am not very much satisfied with the form factor, because although it is lightweight, but still the form factor is quite difficult to hold and stuff. So that was my complete comparison of these three 3D scanners. Hope to see you again. Thank you so much. Bye-bye.